Howdy folks, Keith Bowen here. This is Hard Rock University. And today, inspired by actual events, we're going to show you a few tricks where you can use ordinary steel cable without the proper tools and in ways you might not have thought to turn just a length of cable into a useful tool. Now, cables are used for a lot of things around here, mainly moving rocks. And there's a conventional choker point there for a dead man on a winch. And as you'll notice, they have cable clamps. Everything looks all very neat and tidy. Suppose you don't have the right tools. So let's start with the simplest problem. You have some cable and nothing else, and you need to make a choker. So start with one hard rock with a sharp edge. Another hard rock. Just take the cable, lay it across there, and you can actually cut the cable. Starting to cut here. This is not the most efficient way, but in an emergency, it will in fact work. As you can see, it's cutting through. Now, if all you happen to have is a hammer, it works much better. It works even better if you can find a sharp piece of metal. It's been kind of rounded, but it would still work. But if you got like a piece of angle iron or something with a sharp edge and whack it, it'll cut it really well. Something like these, not so much. I mean, you're never going to do it by hand. You can take them, hold it like this, and then pound it. The problem with that is, for example, these are from Harbor Freight, and I guarantee you they're either going to break or those cutting edges are going to be totally screwed. So just take a sharp piece of metal, hammer, cut it. Now that you've cut the cable to the length you need, how do you make a choker out of it? If you don't have any cable ties or anything like that, with something this small, you can actually tie a knot in it. You know, you could take a big loop and make an overhand knot. And then just pull it. It's going to kind of screw up your cable. It's going to look ugly. It would work if you got plenty of cable and it's light enough like this to do that. You get like half inch or 3/4 inch cable, you're going to be screwed. However, this trick will work even with, let's say I've done half inch cable with a pair of pliers. You can do probably 3/4 inch cable. What you do, you take, this is 7-strand cable. It has one center strand and 6 wrapped around it. You take 3 adjacent strands and start untwisting them. You're probably going to have to retwist the very ends back into their original shape. There we go. Start like that and then just continue to untwist. Okay, this should be good enough. I got about 2 feet here, something like that. Okay, now take the strands, make a loop. Now you can make the loop this big and it will look nicer, but it won't be as strong. Or you can overlap like this, which is what I'm going to do, and you can overlap like this and it'll be even stronger. Take the strands and match them up. Twisting the wrong way. And you can see there will be a point where they will match up like that. Now, I'm going to start at this point here because it makes life a little bit easier. Come on, there we go. Get them matched. Start twisting them together. And as you put it together, you'll notice it forms what appears to be original cable. Just keep working that around. Again, with half inch, even up to about 3/4 inch cable, you can do this with your hands and a pair of pliers. With this 1/4 inch, just my hands is enough. I could actually do this with, you know, rocks and bare hands. Now at this point, you've created a loop. There we go. And then, if you take this around, match it back up again. Now you've got the cable coming through, gripping again, so that these ends can't really start pulling loose when you put tension on it. And then, if you really need it even stronger, you can take tie wire, duct tape, whatever, something just to kind of hold that together. That'll make it even stronger. Now there you have a fairly nice looking loop, and it's actually amazingly strong, just like that. I've hoisted rail cars off the track with like half inch cable with loops just like this. Okay, now by rail cars I mean underground rail cars. They probably weighed, it was empty, so probably about 2 tons. But this kind of cable loop actually supported that. It was, I believe, half inch cable. So let's test this out and see just how strong this is. So here we have the cable. That end is tied, so it should be stronger. This end is just braided, hooked to this winch. And Scotty here has cheerfully volunteered to use his vehicle as a weight and a pull. As far as I get. I don't know about you, but that looks strong enough for most ordinary little uses. And say you wrap it with wire or duct tape or something like that and make it even stronger. You can also run this tail out much farther if you wanted and make it much stronger if you needed to. So there you go. A cable choker without tools. And it will work. Not as well as the official ones, but oftentimes good enough to get the job done, and you don't have to go back to town to Ace Hardware to buy that $2 part that you forgot. There's a number of ways you can rig your anchor to change the length from where your, say, come along is hooking up, or if you're putting a pulley or almost anything else. Now, you can use a chain which is easily adjustable in length. Sometimes you don't have a chain or you need something longer, you can use a choker. Now this gives you your longest reach, and you'll notice I'm hooking it at the bottom of the tree to minimize the chance of ripping it out by the roots, which can happen. Make sure it's well anchored and plenty big enough for what you're going to be pulling. Now, to get it shorter, you can do this. To get it shorter yet, you can do this. You can also wrap the tree again
So there's lots of things you can do to take up the cable and shorten it. Not much you can do to lengthen it, but you can certainly shorten it. And that sometimes is really important. I've noticed that with the come along. We're constantly pulling a rock a certain distance and having to change the anchor length. So those are some tricks there in changing the anchor point distance so that you can use the come along a little bit better.
Thanks a lot, Scotty.
No problem.
Happy prospecting and keep it safe out there.